Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and today we're going to look at deploying the Citrix Access Gateway plugin from within the CAG itself. This video in fact makes the basis for the chapter 6 in my Access Gateway book, the Citrix Access Gateway Essentials. This is available from pactpub.com and chapter 6 is a sample chapter that you can download from the Pact Publishing website itself. The book covers everything that you would need to know about the VPX edition of the Citrix Access Gateway. Chapter 6 is a sample chapter that looks at deploying the Access Gateway plugin so we can have full VPN access to our network and make use of the universal license. In this video, we look at deploying the Access Gateway plugin from the CAG. So in the first instance, I'm working with the Access Gateway and the admin login point. We don't really need to set anything up here, but of course I need a smart access logon point to be able to demonstrate downloading of the Access Gateway plugin. We download the plugin from smart access logon points. So we're logging on using the admin name and whatever we've set the password to. The book will cover in detail how we create all of the resources necessary, so the logon points, the smart groups, the network resources. But as a quick overview, if we drop down to our logon point, and we can see here I've got a logon point called S1. And it's of type smart access. If I choose the edit button, when we open it up, we can see that we're using an authentication profile. So it's allowing me to authenticate to the logon point. There's nothing really else here within the logon point configuration, so I can close that out, move across to my AD authentication profile, and you'll see that this merely points through to my access domain controllers that host my Active Directory. So with that done, if we start looking at what we can gain access to, I've got a network resource. So our VPN will allow us access through to pretty much everything on my 192 network. Initially though, before I can gain access to the network, I'm going to need the Access Gateway plugin. Hence, we're looking in the first instance in Module 6 of installing the plugin. To link everything together, the Access Gateway utilizes smart groups. We can see with a smart group we link then the logon point S1 to the network resources all. So the smart group SG1 links the logon point S1 and the network resource all together. So the process is quite simple, and say during the book we'll look individually at all of these elements and link them together with smart groups. Now we've seen the infrastructure that I've set up, and it really is a very base setup. We're going to take a look at navigating through to that logon point. So in my URL bar we're going to put LP for logon point and then /S1. For the name of the logon point that we were just looking at that we have created. Normally we don't use the browser to access the logon point. We would use the Access Gateway client, but if we don't have the Access Gateway client, this is a mechanism then that we can use to download the Access Gateway plugin. We can see we're presented with the logon screen. Remember, the logon screen is going to tie into my existing Active Directory infrastructure through my authentication profile. Authentication profiles can be used with smart access logon points, such as we're using here, or the basic logon points, which are used for ICA proxy only. As we then log on, we'll see that the Access Gateway plugin is made available for us to download. It's not obvious. It says connect using the method below, and we've got to recognize that that icon is clickable. But when I click on the padlock, it then takes me through to the download page for the Access Gateway plugin for Windows. We can then click on it, save or download it, whatever we want to do. And this becomes one mechanism of deploying our plugin. We of course could download it directly from the Citrix website and distribute it ourselves to our user devices, or we could use the merchandising server, or as in this case, download from the website. If we do download it, then we're able to access the gateway through the programs menu. But if we already have the Citrix receiver installed, it can be managed through the Citrix receiver and we access it through the Citrix receiver. So hopefully you find this section useful and it's tempting you to take a look at the Access Gateway book itself. So remember, you can find that at www.pact.com. Alternatively, you can download it from your reseller of choice, such as Barnes & Noble, Amazon, etc.